Kyle Elihu Onstock, January 12, 1887 to June 3, 1966, 1, was an American novelist, known for his best-selling novel Mandingo, 1957, which deals with slavery on an Alabama plantation with the fictional name of Falconhurst in the 1830s. The book was made into a 1961 play and film of the same name, which was released in 1975. Onstott was originally a dog breeder and judge in regional dog shows, living in California with his widowed mother in the early 1900s. He was a lifelong bachelor, but at age 40, he chose to adopt a 23-year-old college student, Philip, who had lost his own parents. Philip eventually married a woman named Vicky, and the two remained close to Onstott for the rest of his life. Onstott dedicated Mandingo to Philip and Vicky. 4. Onstott began writing Mandingo when he was 65 years old. He based some of the events in the novel on bizarre legends he heard while growing up, tales of slave breeding and sadistic abuse of slaves. Having collaborated with his adopted son on a book about dog breeding, he decided to write a book that would make him rich. Utilizing his adopted son's anthropology research on West Africa, he headwrote Mandingo and his son served as editor. Denlinger's, a small Virginia publisher, released it and it became a national sensation. 5. He was invited to write an article for True, the Man's Magazine, in 1959 about the horrors of slavery. 6. A sequel and a series of other novels followed, mostly written with Lance Horner. Outside the usual setting of their work was the 1966 novel Child of the Sun, recounting the scandalous reign of the homosexual Roman Emperor Elagabalus.
So there you have it. Kyle Onstott. All right. He was born January 12th, 1887, and he passed away on June 3rd, 1966. All right. Kyle Onstott. All right. This is a, I don't know if he was in the closet or not, but it's a gay white man. A gay white man, all right, who was responsible for all of this foolishness. And the modern iteration, the definition of the term Mandingo, right? Mandingo comes from an old crusty ass closeted, probably closeted at the time, a white man and shit. Who, you know, he had a penchant for, you know, men with giant penises. You know, that's appearing in this, one of his last books that he wrote. It was like Empire of the Sun. No, Child of the Sun. It was like an extremely gay book and shit that even gay people at the time thought was like way over the top. You know, some shit set during the Roman Empire. So the main character was like this real life, based on a real life Roman emperor who was a young kid at the time, young gay kid. And he had his way with, you know, buff guys, you know. I didn't read the shit. So yeah, you know. I was inspired to go try to find out where this shit came from, okay? Because, like, in recent times, though, we've, as straight black men, we've been accused of, you know, endorsing the whole Mandingo narrative about how we have these giant phalluses and shit, and we're always chasing after white women and all this bullshit. I got really fucking tired of it. I got tired of it after I read this content creator known as Far East, after how she discounted our situation, our living experience every fucking day in this goddamn country. All right, you can trace all this shit back to some old crusty ass white man. It was gay as fuck. He came up with this derogatory bullshit. You know, he's the one that created the Mandingo novel, okay, which was eventually made into a movie. A novel that has been sold all over the world. It was a sensation from the moment he published it. Right? And he published many sequels and, you know, knockoffs and spinoffs and shit. You know, I can't blame the man for making his paper and shit, but, you know, you can't deny the impact of his writing and what it entailed and shit. Besides, you know, a lot of people point to Birth of a Nation. You know, that first little movie back in the whatever 20s or even before that, that depicted us as savages, killing people and going door to door, sexually being misconduct, conducting misconduct with numerous Caucasian women and shit. Yeah, this shit was wild. It's vivid. You know, a lot of people read this fucking book, man. Yeah, that man think a book. As I recall, you know, I read the fucking book. You know, a long, long time ago in my youth. Yeah, I probably shouldn't have been reading it. But I started with Hear the Falconhurst and shit because, well, because I had a picture of a woman getting undressed on the cover of it. It's a Pulp Fiction novel. It was a, you know, soft cover. Yeah, I recall that at the conclusion of that book, after, you know, the master's wife gave birth to a black baby, the character, the black character who had been sexually compromised and shit because he was a slave, he was literally put in a pot and boiled alive. Yeah, boiled alive. And then, you know, when they did these sequels, every last book ended with the death of scores of black men, slaves. You know, probably, you know, usually in a revolt or doing some crazy shit, you know, because black is, well, you know, we're the boogeyman of the world. Yeah, it's shit like this. It's the power of an image. And, you know, I got to say, you know, a lot of current, you know, current events inspired me to, you know, broach this subject matter. Now, I think I'll take a further look at this subject matter of shit, you know, now that I think of it. But, yeah, here you have the culprit for Mandingo, okay? It's not a black man, okay? And a lot of people, there was a Mandingo tribe in Africa, but that has nothing to do with the current modern day iteration and definition of the word and what it means to most people when they hear it. All right? It's an albatross. All black men have to carry around their fucking neck from the moment of birth to the moment they die, timely or untimely. You know, in you know, my travels in my life, you know, as a Generation Xer, as an elder statesman of this here goddamn community and shit, I can tell you that I have experienced sexual misconduct and people, women saying, women and men actually, saying, you know, off-color shit to me and fucking with me in some kind of way. You know, I responded different ways. But I maintained the job and shit. So, you know, obviously I had some kind of intelligence about how to move in the minority-majority's society and shit. You know, I just, you know, tracing it back to this fucking guy. This old crusty guy. All I got is this fucking one picture of the guy. This is the only picture I have. He, you know, looks like he's near his death. You know, June 3rd, 19th. It's probably him from the 60s. Yeah, he was a gay dude. The same profile. You know, like that Ed Book motherfucker that killed a bunch of brothers. You know, and he was connected to the Democratic Party and shit. You know, it's a long shot and everything. Just roll with me and shit, you know. It's the same kind of profile, you know, and a bachelor, he adopted a kid, but it's a boy and shit, and eventually the boy, you know, got away from him or moderated whatever the abuse he probably was receiving. You know, the kid had, you know, kid had a girlfriend, probably trying to reclaim his manhood. And, you know, paid kid some money or something, you know, kid helped him write some stuff. You know, back in the day, this motherfucker was actually on some panel about talking about race relations. And shit, you know, he was writing some op-ed pieces back in the day about racial, you know, tensions and shit. I like, he made up a book. He made up a fictional book with a fictional plantation and shit, with all this, you know, salacious activity going on between the slaves and their benevolent white masters and shit, who treated them good and shit. It wasn't the slaves' fault that he married a whore. He married this whore in the book. Master Hammond, I think it's the Hammond plantation. Yeah, he's an okay guy. You know, he has a black, he does have a bed wench, okay? In the book, it's a knock to room. But like when they made the movie, it was Pam Grier. I just shake my head every time I look at it because I was like, nah, that ain't what the chick looks like in the book. It's supposed to be some light-skinned chick, you know? Looks all damn near white. She's half white. Pam Grier's, well, you know, she's some sexy chocolate. Anyway. I don't want to get off on a tangent. I wanted to pull the curtain back and I want to show all these misandrists and, you know, these bitches keep talking about how black men is running to white women. They always talk about the fucking white women that we run to. They don't talk about any other race like Chinese, Asian, South Asian, whatever, you know. They always talk about black men and white women. Black men and white women. Well, this is where you get it from, you dumbass. This is your social engineering. This is where you get that shit from, okay? And I want to tell you, it's, you know, you guys think we you know, we're cool with that shit. Yeah, you know, sometimes it's kind of funny when people come up to us, you know, with these preconceived notions. But that shit is a positive and a negative. All right? You got people that think we're gangbangers all the time. We're criminal-minded. We're aggressive. And it's not us. Mostly it's you females. But yeah, I've had women come up to me and do weird shit. I had a chick tell me, yeah, I call it a chick. I had a chick tell me that she loved Negroes. That's what she said. This is a girl that was like 24, 25 or something. She didn't think she should have telling me that. I love Negroes and shit. I've had women try to put their shoe next to my shoe to see my shoe size. And I would oblige them, and then I would like look at them and say, okay, well, what's next? You know? And I had white women just tell, you know, I had it. I've had it. You know, I've had bitches, you know, motherfuckers make three times the shit I make in a year, you know, coming to me saying crazy shit. You know, he's had this one lady was like crazy as hell. You know, she was a terror in the workplace, but she was super nice to me. One day I just had this epiphany, and I looked her up on social media, and she had half black children, and she had a black husband. I just started laughing my motherfucking ass off because I knew she objectified me. And a lot of our women objectify us and shit when they hang these fucking millstones around our neck. This negative representation is not based on any goddamn thing. You guys can't break out of your cycle. A lot of us can't break out of our cycle. Our social engineering is multi-layered. That's the point I'm trying to make. It's multi-layered. I didn't make this video for the bitches that pissed me off talking about, you know, black men and white women ad nauseum. While you're sitting up wearing a white woman disguise and shit. And barring all that, you know, some of you are sitting up dressed as a hotep and shit when you have no ethics whatsoever, no loyalty, no solidarity, no nationality and shit, you know, or nationalism, I guess. I don't know what the correct term is. I just know that it's unfair. And I can't stand on hypocrisy and shit, so I decided to go and pull the curtain back and show you who's responsible for that term, Mandingo, the modern term that refers to tall, you know, well-built black man with a gigantic phallus. A gay man came up with that, a gay white man, and his name was Kyle Onslaught. He was born January 12, 1887, and he died on June 3, 1966. Work well done and shit. He part of the foundation of negative representation of our ethnic group, our gender, going forward into the future. What happens from there? I don't know. I don't know what we do. I say embrace some of this, some of their fucked up misconceptions about us, their ignorance about us and shit, and use it against them. All right, that's what I say. For the women that can't get off the fucking treadmill, I tell you, you know, S-L-I-S-B-M. All right? Be selfish, young kings. Think about yourself. Realize yourself first and whatnot. Otherwise, you're just playing into the system. You might as well just go ahead and, you know, log in and shit, okay? All right? Keep your head on the swivel, brothers.
This message has been paid for by the Dusties. Yes, the niggas you love to hate.